Welcome to the House of Valentina. I'm Valentina and I'm so glad that you've come for a visit today. We're gonna have so much fun today because we are talking about Scandinavia. And for those of you that have visited before, you know, it is a definite passion of ours because we lived in Copenhagen for 6 years and absolutely loved it. And we picked up a few tips and tricks from studying design there for all the years that we were there. One of the things that I absolutely loved about our time in Copenhagen was that I got to style these beautiful, amazing homes. So I thought it would be really fun today to go through some of these hacks, and I found each of them from one room of an apartment that I am so in love with. I could literally just die. Like, I love this apartment so much. And this bedroom in particular is just incredible. And I thought, oh my gosh, what if you could take the same exact principles? Could they apply to another apartment that looks completely different? And sure enough, I found it. So I've got two apartments that will show us how you can take the exact same ideas and get a completely different result. What I hope it will show you is that these ideas can be applied anywhere you live. These are just two apartments, two examples, but I hope what you'll do is you'll take these hacks and incorporate them into your own world, because what we have realized is that you guys are coming from all over the planet. So whether you're in Australia or Canada or Costa Rica or Colombia, you guys have amazing homes, and we don't want you to feel like you have to be limited by what's available to you, but we really want to empower you to be able to create these amazing spaces no matter where you are on the planet. If you watched yesterday's video, those were ideas that you could steal, and these are specific things that you can do in your own home no matter where you are. And I hope that you'll enjoy them as much as I have, because I'm definitely thinking, I'm gonna steal all of these and put them in my house. Hack number one is to really go for it with your trim. Make a statement with your trim work. So often I find that even in this room, we have a little bit of trim. And it's beautiful, and it's one of my favorite things. I absolutely love having trim in here, but there's no trim like this in the rest of the house. So we've been talking about for quite some time what it would be like if we put trim like this maybe in the bedroom, like in this room. Having that beautiful trim is incredible. And I really love ornate trim. I think that there's something really magnificent about it. It's an incredible detail. You can paint it the same color as the wall. You can make it two-tone. You can paint inside of it. There's so many different things you can do with that trim, but I say go for the trim. Make a statement with it, because it's gorgeous. Hack number two is to use statement flooring. Now, a lot of times, statement flooring is very expensive. So instead of a chevron or one of those beautiful parquet floors, which you see in this room, I think another option is to do a reclaimed style floor, whether it's actual reclaimed or it's reclaimed style, something that's got a lot of movement in it and gives you some visual interest. So you can make a statement in more than one way. So definitely go for statement flooring. It will set the stage for whatever else you put into that room, especially if you pair it with that trim. Oh, I get goosebumps. I get goosebumps just thinking about that trim. So amazing. Oh, I gotta have it. I'm like, maybe I'll see if my contractor can tell me how much it would be. He's gonna be like, oh, here's Valentina again. Nothing surprises him. Hack number three is to mix your frame colors. A lot of people ask me this question. I think everybody knows it by now. Like, it's kind of become pretty mainstream that we know that we're supposed to mix our frame colors, but then we just feel a little bit weird about it. And so what I try to do is I try to make sure that they feel like they just go together. Think about what matters to you more than anybody else. And if they feel good to you, then they'll feel good when you walk in the room. That's the most important thing. One of the things that I do try to do is to make sure that if I'm mixing woods, they feel like they're in the same family, or if I'm mixing golds and woods, that they feel like they're in the same level of patina. One isn't like way overly glamorous and the other one like so rustic that they don't seem to have any kind of conversation together. I think when they have a good conversation, you'll feel it and it just feels right. That's what you're looking for. Hack number four is to anchor your space with a rug. A lot of times people will ask me, can I put a rug on carpet? And the answer is absolutely yes. I do suggest that you go with a heavier rug that's not gonna be scooting around on that carpet. Because when you put a rug on carpet, it does have a tendency, if it's a lightweight, to just move all over the place. So go for a heavier weight rug and put that down on your carpet. If you're lucky enough to have hardwoods in your space, I think anchoring it with a rug just sets it apart. It makes it feel complete and the room just feels really happy together. Hack number five is to mix modern with classic. You guys know, you guys know that I love this. You see it over and over and over in my own home, in my own projects, in everything that I present on this channel. I love that mix. I think that it is just pure bliss. But sometimes you guys are asking me, yes, but how do I do that exactly? What exactly does that mean? And I think that there's some really great hacks in these spaces that you can really see how they're kind of played out. In these rooms, they've mixed their lighting. So they've gone for some really modern lighting. It's sitting next to a classic bed. It's sitting next to a classic sofa. And they still just somehow feel like it really is something about that you sense that they just feel like they go together. That's the thing, is it all comes down to what feels good to you. The other ways you can see this playing out in the space is that they've got a modern vase mixed with a classic trim work. They've got a modern vase sitting next to that classic sofa. These are easy ways that you can really blend these styles and it just feels good together. I think another way that you can see it in these spaces is how they've mixed their art. Some of it is very modern and some of it is really, really classic, really traditional actually. And it just, it's weird. It doesn't seem like it should go together, but it just does. Hack number six that I think that both of these rooms represent so perfectly is that they really focus on letting the light in. I think it's interesting that the first apartment has nothing on the windows. They are open, they have no curtains, and the light is just pouring in. That natural light is like, it's like printing your own design money. I mean, it's just, natural light is money. It feels expensive even when it's free. And hey, one doesn't even have curtains on it. So that's an easy thing that anybody can do. Take down the blinds, take down the heavy drapes, and just let the light in. And this other one just has, the other apartment has very, very light, airy curtains. And I think that both just really showcase this idea of letting that light just really pour into the space. It feels good. It would feel good to sit in that space and it just makes the whole room just come alive. Hack number seven that you're gonna see in both of these spaces is that they've mixed wood tones. They've not only mixed it with flooring, but they've mixed it with the actual furniture pieces. And this is another question that I get all the time. Again, I think everybody kind of knows, like, everyone's saying that I can mix wood tones, but can you just like reassure me that I'm actually supposed to mix my wood tones? It's just one of those things that we fret over, right? Because we think, oh, but what if I get it wrong? That's the biggest fear. I've ordered expensive furniture and I got it wrong. I always try to order samples whenever possible. You guys know, if you've hung around here very long, that a lot of times I get furniture given to me because, you know, people are like, moving, I don't know what to do with this, here you go. And I'm like, woohoo. So every now and then it's easy if you can just put the pieces together and see if they go together. Say for example, if you're trying to choose a floor and you're not sure if it's gonna go with your wood dresser that's your favorite that you've owned for a long time and you definitely wanna keep in that space, put the wood sample right up next to it and see if they just feel happy together. And again, it really is about your intuition. You can see that the tones, they just feel like they're right together. They feel like they belong in the same space. They belong in the same family, right? We're not looking twins necessarily, maybe fraternal twins or siblings, and sometimes even cousins. They just feel like they came from the same place and they just work together. And I think that you can mix extremes in one family, and they can be just as gorgeous. So don't be afraid to mix your extremes. You could have something super, super dark mixed with something really, really light, and that could be magical. So just play with it and see what feels really good to you. Number 8 is to layer on the cozy. You guys know that one of my favorite words, if you've been paying attention, is hygge, which means it's like the combination of words that mean perfection, coziness, happiness. It's like this moment in which you just feel so good. It's that feeling. That feeling is what Scandinavians are so good about including in their spaces, and both of these rooms are doing such a great job of adding that cozy factor. You can add coziness through the fabrics that you use. Your fabric choices are huge. That will definitely make you feel more cozy if you choose really soft cottons, really comfy linens. You can see in these spaces how they've made it to where you feel like you could just run and jump onto the bed or just flop down on the sofa. It just feels cozy. And I think the materials are really important. The colors, they feel very approachable. The patterns are really neutral, and all that just kind of plays into it. I think that's really fun, don't you? Hack number 9, in both spaces, you will see this. It's a very Scandinavian thing, is that they always add green. It's very cold and dark for at least 6 months out of the year. I think that was probably the hardest thing that we struggled with when we lived in Denmark, was that it was just dark. You don't see the sun for a straight 6 months, and it's very cold, and it feels like the whole world has gone to sleep and it's just hibernating. And so you need life inside. And that's where that really comes from. And I find myself craving it inside my own home. I just need that greenery inside of my house. And it really does make your spaces come alive. It's literal life. You're literally bringing life into your spaces. And I think that you'll really feel that if you do the same. And I know that we always have this big debate about whether to do faux or real. I do have a video where we talk about that. I promise I will get the video up soon where we talk about indoor plants, because I know so many of you are waiting very patiently for that to come out. I gave a lot of mine away for staging a house. I put them into my homes when I stage them, and they don't have anything on hand. And then we had Corona. So I'm like, oh my gosh, I have no indoor plants hardly to even show you. So that will come soon. But I think if you can add real life, whether it's something rooting in water or a vase with flowers that you've clipped from outside, anytime you can bring actual real life into your space, you will really feel that, and it has an effect on you. I don't know what it is. It just feels alive, and you just feel really happy in there, especially if it actually lives. And on that note, let's end with one that is ironic after what I just said, but the number 10 hack that, again, Scandinavians are so good at is that they use dried flowers. And it seems funny that you're like, oh, dried flowers. And sometimes I look at mine and I'm like, do they look too dead? I don't know, but I just think that there's so much beauty in a floral that has dried, and not everything looks good dried. I just be perfectly honest. Some just need to go. But both of these spaces are just nailing the dried flower hack. They really have things that you know, the pampas grass is a really good one. It has that dried kind of feel, and you can use it in a vase. You can use just a stem. I think these both have really good examples of how you can pull that in without it feeling dead. Dead flowers don't make anybody happy. Dried flowers are like, oh, it's preserved in all time and it's beautiful. I like that. So I hope that it's inspired you to maybe think more about Scandinavian design. And I know some of you are like, oh my gosh, sign me up. I love Scandinavian design. And some of you are on the opposite spectrum where you're like, okay, wait, this isn't what I thought Scandinavian design was. Okay, maybe I'll have to think twice about this. I see a lot of myself in this style, and I'm really enjoying your comments. So leave me a comment below, tell me where you are on that spectrum, and if you already use some of these hacks, or if these have given you maybe some new ideas, or maybe just refreshed something in your mind, you're like, ooh, I gotta go try that. I know a lot of times that's the effect it has on me, where I'm like, oh, I gotta go and redo that, because that is such a good idea. why didn't I think of that before? It was just staring me in the face. I just needed to go do it. So I hope that you will enjoy these. And if you are hanging about on Friday night, we are still gonna do a live at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. All the details will be below in the show notes. And I will leave some links to items that I think you will enjoy and maybe you'll wanna click on. A lot of times you guys are like, yes, but which face? Which rug, Valentina? Which curtain do I pick? So I'll try to put a few of my favorite items down in the show notes. You don't have to buy them. You might even have them on hand, but maybe it'll just kind of jog your memory and give you something to look at. So, okay, I guess that's all for today. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. You guys know I love this. I love these times together. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I will see you very soon. Bye.